Yeah, we define love. Love is you don't want to be alone and you like pussy. That's love.
That's exactly what love
is. Isn't it?
And it can't get any deeper than that.
No. Well, it can.
That's true love.
That's true love. When it goes past 8 inches, that's love.
That's real love.
So, okay, he's done with the Bravada.
Oh, you're right, dude. The red one's in there.
There we go. Whenever you have that kind of problem, Josh.
Uh-huh. WD-40 it. Or whatever.
The shit out of it.
Okay.
Handle and all. And then work the action as much as you can.
Okay. Don't prevent it from doing that again.
Well, that's the hopes. Okay. Just unhook that and put the charger on it where it sits. Or you can take it out. You already got it, so.
Oh.
Whatever. At least it didn't get stolen. Okay. The question is, if this thing's buffed, you washed that blazer?
I did, yeah.
And that's how the windows look? Something got fucked up along the line somewhere. You did it after you washed it, really?
I wiped them all down. I didn't do a good job, apparently.
Well, no, you did this. You scraped this off after you washed it.
Oh, right.
I got it now.
I gotta give another wipe down. That
you know area. What? We're gonna have to go over wiping again. See the difference? It's like on that Mercur. It's the same thing. You're getting.
Water marks and everything, and or the towel was too wet.
You know, it's kind of like a 60-year-old whore. You're kind of leaving a snail trail everywhere.
I did notice that.
And this here, I think we might do. They were pretty bad, but buffing it. So you don't know what you're working on now, Josh?
I'm gonna take that. So take the battery out, and then are they gonna wash the Jeep?
We're going to move that. So yeah, keep doing the battery and we'll know in a second here. What did you do to these wheels? Degreased them?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Bring me the mothers and a terry cloth towel if you would while we're talking. Okay, so buffing it's going to get a lot of this out. And he's got enough to buff on it.
Yeah.
So maybe I think I should buff it a little, especially while it's up like this. It makes it so fucking easy. Versus,
oh my god,
my back hurt just like showing. Yeah, that tailgate looks so nice. The tailgate looks so much for the hell of it. Okay, Google Glass video. Prank. Just get that tire off.
Get the tire off?
Yeah.
Okay.
We're not gonna use this thing? Well, not to just loosen it up. To just loosen it up, we'll just put it on and...
So loosen it up
lefty
first?
Lefty-loosey. Yeah, loosen it up before we... And we're not going to use that jack. We'll do it different, but like, yeah.
Okay.
Just get it loose and... Then I'll jack it up.
Okay.
Okay, this might be interesting.
Good.
Okay. I'm going to go ahead and zoom this up. And slip this out here.
There.
Huh? Well, it's a Mercedes. Them things are tight, yeah. I don't want to go out there too soon. But I do want to go out there. We're going to bust his balls a little bit. Did you take one off or no? You didn't take one off? Okay. Don't bust your knuckles now.
I don't know if it's going to work.
What?
Well, I only got like 130 pounds here to go on there.
Well, somebody got it on there.
Like...
Dude, come on, I could jerk off harder than that.
Dude, this is, these are on there.
Hey, Chuck. He's having a problem. Did you open up your wrench?
Would that help?
I don't know. You think that'll help?
Probably. And then go down like this.
Don't break, don't snap that thing. I'll run your hand right in concrete.
Come on, you got more power than that, don't you?
Dude, I'm like putting all my weight on it. Like, what else can I do?
What else can you do? I'd try.
Is it like WD-40?
WD-40. I'd try putting your weight on it. I'd try putting my foot into the thing. What'd you do?
Touch this.
Holy smokes, yeah, that's hot. Don't do that.
Oh, don't carry your flop-flops.
Yeah, you got flop-flops on, so be careful.
Flop-flops. Well, let me get some WD-40 on that.
WD-40 ain't going to help a lug nut on a tire.
Okay.
You want your brakes to get slippery?
Oh, yeah, right.
Power?
You got a power tool to do this?
Right there?
There you go, yeah. So, hold on, I'll give you a scenario. You're along the highway coming from Kennebunkport, Maine. Okay. You pack down. You're heading here.
You got your 16-year-old girlfriend with you with a note from the dad and everything.
Oh, yeah, right. Consent.
What did you?
You're going to look pretty funny changing your tire, dude.
How are you going to make her happy if you can't get your nuts off the tire?
If you can't get your nuts off here.
How are you going to make her happy? This happened once before and I couldn't do it either.
Really?
I had to bring it to
and she left? She left?
Well, no, we were with a couple friends, and they weren't impressed.
I'm just kidding.
They all tried to help.
Well, I'll give you one clue. You're starting out with no room to go.
No room to go. Okay.
Yeah.
So what should I do? So start up here?
Hey. I wouldn't go too high. You are seriously, like, just not putting more than about 14 pounds of pressure on there.
That was I'm like lifting myself up.
You ever heard of leverage?
Yeah.
Okay. You think you
this is leverage.
Is it? It was more leverage. You're right. That's good. You're gonna get a gold star. Well, red star for that one.
Yeah.
Red star.
Well, pink.
Oh.
Pink star. Purple's next if you really do.
I see purple coming now.
Do you know how much it's costing me to get this tire off right now?
I hear you, man.
Are we going to have to call AAA?
Tray, just no lug nuts?
Yeah. AAA would, that might be a good idea, getting AAA down here.
No, I was just going to...
So what are they going to do? Send another guy?
I guess I'm going to have to go buff while he does this.
He's going to show up and do the same thing. Oh, we're going to have to call Quadruple A.
What happens when AAA can't get... I heard something.
I think it was a transmission.
I think he broke the tranny. Josh, he broke the tranny.
Oh,
he's got one.
I got one.
He's gonna be warm plum out. You know, like this 5 minutes and 31 seconds or so. So like I don't think we're gonna have time to let him get a second one. I think we're just gonna have to take it off, but it's kind of fun.
And then do it with slow, steady, so it's slow to eat.
All you gotta do is lean into it, and next will be hard. He's got that one threaded out now. This is the second one or the first one? First one. Third?
Well, it's easy when you know the trick.
What's the trick?
Wibble wobble, back and forth. That's it. How you doing? You just gotta get that leverage, just like when you push the car, you go back and then you go forward. Until finally, it gives way. Just gonna keep on doing this.
See, like...
That might please your girlfriend.
Yeah, I mean, she might get a lot of fun out of that. You're right. You do that for about 45 minutes while she's in there. She's going to be all warmed up for you, dude. Oh yeah. She turned that little seat heater on.
Okay. Look, you're doing a wheelie.
Yes. In that vert.
Oh, you're stubborn.
Beast mode.
I could have given up on that in like the first 10 seconds.
And what would you have done?
Called
AAA.
Yeah, right. I really didn't think I was going to be able to do it.
You want to get that last one real quick, Chuck?
Which one did you get?
That one, I believe.
This one right here?
Yeah.
Oh, not loose?
Yeah. Well, aren't you... Try rocking the car, Chuck.
I did it.
What it was.
Did you get them all?
Yeah, I got them all.
Gee. Except for that one that you just saw.
Well, then that would be your first tire, huh?
Yeah.
Wow.
That is bad. Not bad.
We had to tighten that one back up to where you can say you got them all.
Yeah, just to finish it up.
Okay, so what are you doing? You're moving this?
Move this. I'm going to... Yeah, move this.
Before we move that...
And try the car if I have a few minutes in between.
Let's try that first.
Do it.
And then that way we can move this forward, move the Jeep in here, and all we gotta do is back that out and push that out. We'll have to bring the Caddy in here. Great. Basically, we're gonna put the 300E where the van is.
Okay. Now, while we got this couple of these things out, do you wanna try to get that?
The Camry? The 300E makes it hard.
It does.
And they are supposedly coming today.
Okay,
well, I'll know more in 20 minutes.
Yeah,
and you'll know more on if it runs or not. So you'll know if it runs. You're going to see if that runs. So you'll know if both these run next time I see you.
Next couple minutes. I'll do that right
and
now.
And, like, are you... There's a big cluster under there, like a point you can put that jack cradle right around.
Yes.
It's kind of like...
Yeah, there's a little plastic bushing. You can cup. Put it right on it.
Like, not on the, it's on the side, though, right? You know what I mean?
Underneath, yep, yep. Can't see. I mean, you can see it, but you...
They tell you online to jack it up behind the tire, but it's a plastic piece that busts.
Right there.
No, no, no.
Oh, that's where the jack goes.
Josh, right? I mean, Chuck, right here.
Okay, yep, yep.
This one's too. It'll bust this.
Okay.
And yeah, that does work easy, Josh, if you got it, but we've got a floor
yeah.
jack.
Oh, and that's probably...
But I just cradled a big one.
And they do work good.
Oh, yeah.
Mercedes had a
I like the little jack.
Here's a quicker,
though. Then you're just right back on to buffing, right, Josh?
After I'm done with this?
Okay. And then after you're all buffed and we're all done with it, probably about lunch or what? Well, that was fun. Stoked because it's louder.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Huh?
My Montana. Parking sensors.
Huh. Yeah.
Seat pulls down, third row. And you got the third one that comes out to where you got to walk through like mom lives. Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah.
Look at this.
It's fast. The way he drives it,
it's a fast little van. Yeah, on the highway you get about 28. Look at this. Watch. So nice.
Rogers has a button here.
Yeah, there's a button.
Yeah, there's a button.
Is there?
Yeah.
It's hidden.
Oh, it's up higher. Yeah. Rogers is down lower.
Only this door is automatic.
Well.
Kind of cool.
Yeah.
And it's got the sport package, so look from the front. It's pretty sporty for a fucking minivan.
Yeah, fog lights.
So, okay, you got to see the S500 while you're here, too, or the CL. He's fine.
What's up, dude?
Chris, how's it going?
Good. So all four of us, all five of us can lift that off of there?
Probably could. I don't want to.
Well, I need to use the truck.
How about that? Huh? I don't need it. I don't need it. I've told you that. You can
I'm just wondering with that.
Oh, you need the trailer, too.
Yeah. Well, no.
Okay, I'll unload it. I'll unload it. Yeah, I can have it unloaded tomorrow, but not that.
Well, I can bring Refugio and...
Well, I figured...
Well, I'm going to bring the CLK.
I figured I could back this up somewhere and tie a chain to one of my trucks and then just pull the trailer forward with it tilted down, and I can slide it right off.
Oh, that's true, too.
So, like this... Open the door, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Drive some screws in there.
We're gonna take the panel off from the inside.
Yeah, maybe.
And smack it out and try and do it without breaking the window.
Yeah.
First thing in the morning, so you know for our list, a wash on this will be the most important thing.
Jeep?
No, on this thing.
Oh, the Bravada?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna write that down.
That way we can get the wax off.
Okay.
Aerosweet.
That's that little fat bastard to sit there in that chair and sit there. He's a cool guy.
Yeah.
God, he's got a way of 450.
Mm-hmm.
He got a little thing to scoot around on now. Kind of cool, huh?
Yeah.
Last year.
Run good and everything?
Oh, yeah. Needs a
AC work?
Needs a compressor.
Air conditioner compressor?
So we're going to look at the junkyard on Thursday.
Yeah.
When we go to Odessa. Yeah. The coops both roll up. Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah.
And then there's that.
The Jeep?
Uh-uh.
Oh, the motor?
You want to tell him about it?
About the motorhome?
Yeah. So he ain't got nowhere to live, and Chuck and his kids are coming down next Friday, so that we're kind of fulled up.
It was only five. It was like on Craigslist for 700.
Yeah.
I got it for five.
Yeah, 5,000, huh?
500?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, 500.
No, I don't. I couldn't afford that.
Well, the tires are worth 400.
Really?
The tires are pretty nice.
The tires are brand new.
Yeah, geez, that's already a good deal.
Oh, yeah.
We got lawn. Isn't there lawn chairs in there, too?
Yeah, there were. There were a couple.
Nice ones. And
nice.
We got
a... Crazy.
He
said there were some tums. I got heartburn.
Yeah, it's in the cabinet, the medicine cabinet.
It's in the medicine cabinet in there now.
They're smoothie flavored. They're good. I took a couple. Just because. Oh, did you move them?
No.
No, they're in the bathroom.
Oh, in the bathroom, Chuck.
Chuck, the other bathroom.
Chuck, the bathroom.
Oh. Jeez. Are you Polish, Gursky?
But it's
ski.
Only like 40-something
thousand
miles.
Is it?
Yeah, Gursky? No, it's German. His dad's German.
What's the difference? Polak, German, whatever. How many miles?
48.
Wow.
Low miles.
Yeah, it's real low. Needs a tranny.
But it starts right up.
Mine needs a tranny, too.
That one?
My Mercedes.
Does it really?
It's banging.
What's it got on it now?
102.
That's it.
But I got a brand new transmission in my other car that I...
Oh, you're gonna swap it out?
Yeah.
Nice.
He's got it. He's got it. Are you going out? Give me 1 minute. Yeah, he's going out. We gotta go. Sorry. Sorry, man.
It's all right. Man, I've seen that car around for years, man. I've seen it in a magazine one time.
Yeah, they put it all over Facebook and everything all the time. You go to the Mercedes dealership and that, the whole place stops and comes outside. And they always get, why did you do that to that car?
No, it's fine.
Sorry about that.
No problem.
Holy fuck, who was sitting over here? Paul Bunyan? We're gonna make it. We're gonna. Well, thank you.
There's 12 of us.
Oh, I don't know, that isn't gonna work. I don't think that'll work. Yeah, I think that's it. Yeah, see, it's saying that's too much stuff.
Yeah, overload.
Oh, God, I hope it breaks. We'd be set.
Wouldn't
they? It's only 2-3 stories.
Yeah, yeah. Ain't nobody getting on here. Is this cool?
Yeah, yeah. This is
wow.
It.
Wow. See, that would have been worth the fall. You got a card?
Yeah.
Do you really?
Yeah.
I didn't bring mine. I just came for the scones. Do I have to order food, or can you just bring me scones?
Yeah.
Looks like I came for more than the scones. I got these expired condoms with me. I put that picture up because it was expired, and like, serious man, you gotta use that up or where you lose your time. See, dude, if you don't seize the day and take that picture of them condoms and put them up soon, then the time expires and it's not funny anymore. That sucks. I had a deadline. Good, how you doing? I need to get a couple cards. I need two of them to where I can really go to town.
You had one before?
Oh yeah. One out of four, what's that, the odds of getting a chick pregnant with a condom?
Who knows? I mean, that's not... Depending on the brand, I guess, maybe. Yeah, like yours that are getting expired.
I think it's one out of 20.
Seriously?
Or maybe it's one out of 60. Isn't it like 95% effective? I don't know what they are. You got
still a chance you can get pregnant with a condom.
Oh, yeah, pull out too, dude.
Wow, I didn't know.
It's condom and pull out.
Yeah, I know, you've mentioned that you're a little extra careful.
Oh, dude, them chicks be keeping that shit in their mouth, going to the bathroom and keep that shit.
That is, I mean, do you really think that there's some...
Do I think?
Some girls have done that.
Yeah.
To you.
Not to me.
But you've heard about it.
They ain't gonna get my sperm. My shit stays with me. You take a condom, tie that shit up, and fucking put it in a little towel and take it out with you. You don't leave that shit around to where any bitch can grab a hold of your man cum.
Oh, imagine that.
Yeah,
the
fucking
they actually go into the trash and try to get it out. And...
It's good for a while.
Is it really? Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Doesn't it?
The half-life of cum. I don't know what that
is. Your half-life?
Yeah. Is that what they call it?
Oh, yeah, it is.
I think it is.
For chemicals and stuff, the half-life. Well, can't be more than a day.
What?
Well, still, that's enough time for them to go. They all want to go to the bathroom afterwards and stuff, you know?
Air?
As soon as your cum hits the air, it's...
No.
That's what I thought. I thought it has to
no,
be
you
direct
in. Well, you shoot it in a bag.
That's
it's
something to Google.
It's not hitting no air.
You think so? Maybe I know that for sure in a bag.
Oh,
think.
Absolutely. It's live.
I'm just scared either way.
There's all kinds of swimmers.
Hello?
Hi, is this Nathan?
Hi, what can I do for you?
Oh, I'm watching your video on a motorhome. That I'm interested in?
Oh, I don't have any motorhomes right now. I'm sorry.
Oh, wow. Okay, can you tell me how much you sold that 84 Lazy Day motorhome?
No, I don't. I can't. That's been a while ago. I do have one kind of like that one coming up in about, 2 or 3 weeks. I've got a nice, it's a little bit long. It's about 2 feet longer. It's an 89, actually.
Okay.
It's about as nice and all, but that one is about, before we do anything else to it, I think we could let it, I got a guy on it that's wanting to get rid of it. He's kind of using it right now, but I think we take about
$3,800. Okay, and can you tell me, now Nathan, on that, How many miles is on that one?
It's got 48,000 miles on it. And basically, it's really nice. It was an army lady that had it. And the thing that we're deciding now which, like that, it has a bad transmission. I can have a rebuilt one for $1,200, and I would be asking more, like $4,900. But I hate to put the trannies in them, because if you pay somebody to do it, then you get the warranty. If I pay him to do it, there's no warranty, and you won't get a warranty. So I mean, that's the kind of the breaking point there. But that thing is nice. It's tight. It don't leak. Just had a new roof put on it. It is a nice RV. So.
And is it a Chevy?
It's a Ford. Was that Lazy Days was a Chevy?
That's what I wrote down.
Oh, it probably was. You're probably right. I'm thinking about it. It probably was. But
right.
Yeah, that's it. I'll have it up on my site in about 2 or 3 weeks. But definitely.
Okay, great.
Okay.
Okay, honey. Thank you.
Thank you. Call anytime.
Uh-huh.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
She called you honey.
She just made this an election day for me almost.
For sure, yeah.
Give me an election.
An election? Big old fat throbbing election.
She's interested at $3,800, dude.
Mm-hmm.
That's not enough markup, is it, Josh?
I was surprised. $3,800? I was like, wow.
Well, we're trying to make a living here, right?
That's true.
We got to make our bread for, like, doing this.
That's a pretty good flip, only spending $500 on it.
We got AAA to pay.
No, not really.
Well, I'm saying there's...
We would have if you would...
Cost of acquisition.
And I got that tire off today, there would have been AAA to pay.
Oh, yeah, if I didn't get that tire off.
For sure.
I was serious, too. Like, I really didn't think I was going to get that thing off.
What'd it take?
Just had to get the leverage and
the last
go back
holes
and forth.
And elbows, right?
Right.
Like scrubbing on the car.
The best way is to put your foot into it. It'll get you a lot to put your foot into it.
Or your back to it.
Just don't give up.
On the little lug nuts?
I think it might save time if he...
Got a car rocker? He's the one to push it back and forth for him?
There you go.
No way.
Yeah, if you just put the wrench on there and held the wrench and had a couple guys push the car back and forth, we might be able to get them things.
Okay, guys, go. What was you going to say? I'm sorry.
I can't remember. I forgot.
Damn it.
I got a little short-term memory loss.
Oh.
Self.
I'm right there with you.
Diagnosed.
Yeah, same.
I think it was self-diagnosed. I forget now.
Dr. Chuck?
Dr. Chuck.
Dr. Shuckery? I'm going to picture the caddy for sure. Fucking thing dies every time you come up to a light.
What?
Okay.
Yeah.
It was driving fine yesterday, wasn't it?
Uh-uh.
So now it
died every time we went up to a light.
Did I say that? Okay.
Donnie, did he say that?
So when you get up to a light, it dies.
Wait a second. What are you saying? The Cadillac?
Normally, I think you're being.
Did I say that?
Normally, I was thinking he was being a smartass, but you're serious.
That's what he just said.
There you go.
God dang.
I knew I said that. Yeah, it dies when you come to a light.
Well, we went to Albertson's the other day and it was fine.
We didn't hit no lights. No, that was quick, dude.
That was hot.
I think I started before he even ended the sentence.
Could be an alternator. It's running out of. Do you think it might be an alternator?
It's running out of alternation.
It alternates between running
and stalling. You get stuck on stall.
That
could be
run.
That.
My mom's Dodge Charger used to do that.
Your what?
My mom's Dodge Charger.
Did you say mom?
Whatever it's called.
Do you watch Family Guy? Or just...
No, I do. I do.
So is that why you do it, Stewie?
No, I'm just talking normal here. But at a stop sign.
Spell it.
No, that's a good one. Me and Colin were giving him a hard time.
He wouldn't say it
that time.
Would you spell it?
We never thought about asking him to spell it.
Spell it for me.
M-O-M.
Wow.
Then why the hell are you putting you in? You say it.
I don't.
Say it.
Mom.
He knows he doesn't.
It's not even silent you either. It's a loud you.
It's like a fuck you you.
No.
It's just the way I say it.
Say what?
So when you...
I'm not going to say it again.
Hold on. You sound like you grew up with the monsters.
The monsters.
Oh, yeah, the monsters.
With the monsters. Mummy. Mummy.
That's a good show.
Could you say that when you was little, Mummy?
I guess.
Say Mommy.
Mommy.
Mommy. Wow. You say Mommy, don't you?
Mommy.
Oh, my God.
Do you say Mommy or Mommy?
I'm not making fun of you. Which is,
you don't know. Okay, dialect. That means Mummy. Dialect. Ka. Isn't it weird how it goes from something kind of tough sounding like ka?
Yeah.
To mom.
Right, right.
If you got a tattoo, would it say you or uh-oh?
I don't know.
You know what? Somebody should really take advantage of it and start spelling it with a U and own that shit.
Yeah, what's that tattoo on your arm?
Mom.
Oh, it's a loving memory of my mom. M-U-M. Who the hell is that?
I wonder if they spell it that way in like, UK.
No.
No, he says just no.
He is mispronouncing it so bad.
They all say that over there.
No, M-O-M.
It's like an
say
East
it.
Coast
mom.
Thing.
No.
Well, how do you say it?
Mom.
Mom. Adjective. Mom. Silent.
That sounds right to me.
Well, that makes sense.
What?
Mom. Adjective. Silent.
Yeah, mom's the word.
Mom's the word. Yeah, exactly.
That's the only time you use mom. Mom's the word.
Well, no, I thought...
Your mom told you shut up all the time. Mom. That's why she called you mom. Mom.
Mom, mom.
See, but in Wiktionary it says, I don't think mom would like you.
Yeah, I mean, that person can't keep his mouth shut.
It may still have the pronunciation of mom, but be spelled mom. Or mom and be spelled mom.
But yeah, so when she would stop at the stop sign...
Hold on, who's she?
Mom, my mom.
Oh, we're going back to this again.
She would stop at a stop sign, the car would completely stall out, and she'd have to start back up, and our mechanic figured it out that it was the alternator that was causing that to happen. So that sounds like a similar symptom.
I would believe it if it didn't run so rough.
Oh, so you think it, okay. Like a mass airflow, whatever the heck.
Something like that.
Oh, whatever the heck. I'm going to look that up on eBay.
Yeah, but eBay doesn't realize that when you say whatever the heck. Got.
You gotta add the emphasis to body
you
language.
You gotta have your camera on when you do it.
Do you click, make a video? Gotcha.
Airflow sensor and whatever the heck. After recognizing your head shake, this is what I found on the web.
Is there an engine light on the Cadillac? But it's too old for the OBD2.
No, there's no engine light.
Kenobi.
There's no engine light at all.
There's no engine light on. There's a brake in the ABS.
Well, that's weird.
Yeah, you said the brake went out.
Even though the brake light's on.
No, the brake light went out.
Oh, went out.
Brake light's off.
Even when you put the brake on, the brake light's off.
Okay, so that's a...
It's not broke.
It's not broke.
Forget about the brake light right now. Take that right out of it. You,
the brake's not... The brake is not broke. The brake's not broke.
I want you to leave your mom on the street now.
What kind of car is it again?
91 Deville.
91.
Sedan Deville.
Cadillac Deville. Stalling.
Let's just get off of mom's now, because I just got off of yours. Remember that one?
Yeah. You leave my mom out. Oh, you want your mom out? You want your mom out? What time you want the bitch back?
Josh, you're going to have to start utilizing your cupboards, huh?
No, we got plenty of counter room.
What?
Your cupboards.
Oh, yell
cupboards?
At him.
Yeah,
I'm not yelling. Are you yelling
at you? Your cupboards.
Oh, yeah, my cupboards.
Cupboards. What do you call them?
Right, yeah, I'm right on the
drawers. Drawers. Drawers in the sky.
I didn't even notice they were up there.
Oh, the cubbies?
What would you call them, really?
Compartments.
Compartments.
Drawers?
See, because like I noticed, like,
mom's drawers.
Mom's drawers. No, never mom's. I'm not allowed to go in them. No, if you notice at the grocery store, the different language too. Did you notice a different language there last night?
Who?
He wanted a carriage.
Who did?
Okay,
you did.
Somebody said we get a carriage.
Oh, I love all that shit.
But like that's what they call them there.
Carriage.
A carriage, right? That's
what
you said.
Them?
A carriage. No, yeah. We don't call them a carriage.
What do you call them?
Carriage. A shopping carriage.
Is it called a shopping carriage? Is
Shall
it?
I grab a shopping carriage?
No, I left it in the garage.
Oh, grab me a pint of lager.
We have 3/5 in the foyer.
Crepes?
No, we call them a cart. We call them a cart and listen to the world.
Yeah, a cart.
Like a shopping cart.
That's what it is.
You really said
carriage? Do they call it a carriage? Do they call it a shopping carriage over there?
Hold on. Carriage. What's the difference between cart and carriage?
Not a shopping carriage.
A shopping carriage would be too much. Like, you know what it is. It's a carriage.
Well, a cart wouldn't be enough.
What's the difference? A cart, you haul something. A carriage has people in it.
You might be right. I don't know.
Like a carriage and buggy?
Yeah.
That's what I think of when I think of carriage. You're right. Exactly. Oh. Or I think of a baby carriage.
Yeah.
Still hauling a person.
It depends on the context.
You're right on that, too. But no, I've totally heard it. I'm not making fun. I've heard it. I've heard it referred to as a, well, I guess we are kind of making fun in a certain way. But
oh, absolutely.
Carriage. Transporting of items or merchandise from one place to another.
There we go. What's a cart?
A shopping cart, a baby carriage, a four-wheeled passenger vehicle pulled by two or more horses. That's number one.
It's That's a cart!
Number one, the number one meaning of a carriage is a means of conveyance, in particular, a four-wheeled passenger vehicle pulled by two or more horses. Number two is a baby carriage. Number three is a shopping cart. A wheel support for moving and heavy objects such as a gun. Oh, yeah. So it's like a cannon.
A cannon or a gun. That's pretty cool. But it says shopping cart.
A passenger car or cane. Or a train. The first one is a horse. The second one is a baby carriage. The third one is a shopping cart. A shopping cart is one of the first of the ones. Two. Three. Wow, there's a lot of them. A person's bearing or deportment. Huh?
Really?
Carriage. The harboring a potentially disease-causing organism by a person or animal that does not contact the diseases.
Jeez. You're a host?
That sounds more like a host.
Yeah.
That sounds more like a fucking outbreak monkey.
That's exactly what that sounds like.
An outbreak monkey.
I don't know. What else you guys say it's all fucked up?
That have short-term memory?
You can tell me something. Well, I'll be having a notebook writing it down, and I'll forget what I'm supposed to write down in a notebook. I was supposed to remember, you know.
What notebook?
That's even a shorter memory.
A what?
I gave you a notebook. What?
A memory. Oop, don't get that in your eyes.
Ooh. What are we going to Walmart for?
Who, where?
Notebook.
Going where?
I think if, like, you say something out loud, it helps remember, too.
I know if every time I crawled in the sack with, if I had a wife and I crawled in the sack with her, knowing that she was, like, carrying somebody else's baby had been carrying else's baby, it'd be kind of a tough.
Especially if you think you're the father or you don't even know about it. I mean, what the hell?
Yeah, well, especially if you know that you're not the father and it was a meth head and then you're going to get down there and please her.
And until you find out that she's pregnant, I mean.
He's like, don't eat that stuff.
Right. Yeah.
No, don't eat that.
He's down there just eating away, and she's all like, yeah, if you saw some of the dick that was in there, you wouldn't be eating that, honey.
How could she do that? How could she live with that? Go to sleep with him every night knowing that she let someone else impregnate her?
She's a crackhead.
Yep.
How is she?
And I could give two fucks. I did what I thought was right, and if I was in the same situation, I'd do it again.
Wow. So even That's though it allegiance. Backfired on you, it's still worth doing.
That's an allegiance. Why? Because if I had a best buddy, I'd want him to tell me.
That's a good point.
And then I did. Sweep it up the rug.
I did. Yeah, like the first time I met her, I said, Chuck, she's a bitch.
She's a bitch, and I should have listened. It would save me a lot. But she's a cunt. She can't help it.
Cunts can't help being cunts.
Cunts can't help being cunts. Mm.
Cunts for cunts. There should be a page for that on Facebook.
I mean, I don't hate the bitch.
You don't hate her?
I don't hate her.
I bet she convinced him, though, that you were lying.
Oh,
So he still...
He switched bitches, didn't he?
No, he's still with that bitch.
I thought you were talking about your bitch.
Oh, well, yeah. Well, she'd get finger banged by a Wolverine, bro. I give a fuck. I hate that cunt.
Would that be paw banged?
It'd be paw banged.
I'd be dead.
It's just how you roll, man.
You're unique.
Yeah. special. You're special. It's like, was your school bus long or short, young man? It was longer than my car.
It was a big bus. That was three rows.
The big, big bus. It's this big. I rode in back.
Really? You rode in the back? Yeah, the only way back in the third row.
You had a wamp.
Oh, man.
Wamp, wamp.
Sometimes Stacy would smash your head against the window really hard and then lick it. Bobby sat right next to me and he ate crayons.
Oh my god. I bet you says crayons.
Mom? Yeah. Crayons.
Crayons?
No.
How do you say crayons?
Crayons. Crayons.
I don't know if there's a right or wrong.
Say beer.
Cath. It could be right.
Beer? I like... Beer. Or...
I like calves better than cars.
Yeah, calves.
I like it better than cars.
What kind of accent? What kind of accent you have?
I don't think I have an accent.
Another one.
Nobody thinks they have an accent.
Another
really?
One. Yeah.
So even people from Britain don't think they have an accent.
Really?
Yeah. Somebody might realize at some point, but.
Well, I guess it's a good.
I get told I have an accent, from Northwestern type accent. Northeastern's definitely an accent. It's not South Dakota Canadian accent, but there's
right,
definitely more of a.
Deeper.
Oh, holy hell, there, hey there.
Oh, there.
How are you, like, Colin?
Oh.
Hey, buddy, I'm not your guy.
Hey. What's it?
Hey. I wanted to write up a bunch of gadge. You can't say garage either.
Up the gate.
I wanted to write up a list of things with, like, all those Canadian words that he can't say. Like, having to say them all.
Work on these. My vocabulary.
Well, we just recorded a video of him saying it, but like I never did it. Man.
Then you got Southern. Put your titty back in, mama.
Remember that? Fucking love that movie.
What movie is that?
California.
California, Brad Pitt. California with a K.
Huh. I haven't seen that. Dude. Was it funny? With Brad Pitt?
Yeah, but there was a funny part.
It was before he was pussified.
It was really like one of his first movies, yeah.
Before he was pussified?
And this one back when he was.
Yeah, he's like.
Ass fucking Jennifer Aniston.
Now he just gets straight sex.
Now he just gets, yeah. From.
Angelina?
Missionary style only. He is with Angelina Jolie, huh?
Jolie. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Bradgelina?
Don't they, like, adopt a bunch of kids?
What do you consider a lot?
Doesn't she have like a bunch of babies?
African? That's kind of racist.
That's horrible.
That's horrible.
That's horrible.
I guess it's not racist when you think about it.
No, it's not. They were African kids.
So black.
She's trying to not be racist.
Man, yeah, she cut her tits off. What's that got to do with race?
Did she really?
I think she did too.
Can't have either one.
I think it was like cancer.
Breastalina.
Pretty sure she had cancer in her breasts.
She
her,
did not.
Her mother had it or something.
She had pre-cancer cells.
Yeah, I think that's what it was. She cut them off.
That'd be like saying one of my left nuts is swollen up. Now you don't.
That took care of that. Three rows. I think we've made full circle on our stand-up routine now.
Right.
You can tell it's about mid-show. We came back around and made the hooks.
We'll grab a smoke.
Three rows. That sucks now, like stand-up comedians, like a lot of them, I'll bet you they can't smoke on the stage.
No, probably not. Probably not. Well, why not, though?
Rich, my buddy Rich, I think you've met him.
Fat?
He's been up to your house. No, Brockman. Uh-huh. The one eye.
Mm-hmm.
Stayed there up to your house. He lives down here in California.
Where at?
Up north, I'm not sure. I got him on Facebook, but he's actually a real stand-up comedian. And he's, you know, he travels around the circuit.
Do they have fake ones?
Huh?
They have fake ones?
Well, I mean, this girl, he said something rude, and she's like, aren't you a comedian? And he said, actually, I am. And he sent a link to one of his shows he did.
So he showed her up.
So, yeah. So he really.
She missed her thing. She should have said, that's not funny.
Oh, he was so vulgar and rude.
Yeah, that's not funny.
Just because a girl dressed like that doesn't mean she's a whore. And he said something about... I can't remember.
See, I'm on the opposite end of that, and I just got in big discussions about that because, like,
about girls dressing.
Dress like a whore. You're a whore.
I'd say so.
There's no two ways about it. You don't have to like be asking for money for sex to be a whore.
No.
And I looked up the description just for that.
Right.
You can sell your fucking morals and like just have less morals and you're a whore.
That's the thing. A whore doesn't less respect yourself. I don't think.
Yeah, no self-respect in whore.
That's not possible to be a self-respecting whore.
Is it? Think about that. That's a Twitter post. Is it possible to be a self-respecting whore?
Yeah, that would get some people thinking.
I guess it would, as long as you were only doing it for money.
If you're doing it for money?
Yeah.
Well, that's a prostitute.
But it doesn't have any self-respect. It doesn't have any self-respect issue, does it?
No, there's no self-respect in prostitution.
Is there or isn't there?
I don't think so.
I mean, how does it lose any self-respect? It's just fucking...
You're selling your body...
For money. Does the value, does the amount of money make it whether or not it's self-respect? Yes. If you're selling your dick for $50.
Well, that's the thing.
I mean, I was gonna say vagina, but I don't have one.
So your your self-worth is based on a quick $50.
Well, right. You just said 50 or 100, but what if it was 500? Now do you have a self...
Okay.
Now all of a sudden, it might not be such a self... Now you can still have some self-respect.
Some money, right?
Yeah. Especially a chick, because that's like... They got the whole fucking whore thing down because they can just like bang all day.
And they probably don't care. I mean, they probably doesn't... They're probably just running to the bank laughing.
I would think so. I mean, a guy like... You better get a big money per pop because you're only going to get 2, 3, 4 a day. And that's about it.
You're drained out.
What happened? Did she come back?
Oh no, I'm trying to figure out that.
Fucking bitch.
I know what.
No, Breeder, it's just a rough life over here, huh?
No.
3 minutes to spare, video is up. Ching ching.
You got a video up? Of what? Auction?
Oh, loading a car.
Oh, loading a car, nice.
What do they call a dike that leaks?
I think you said that earlier.
I don't know. I was just thinking about that because the Dutch boy and the finger in the dike. Finger dike.
Finger dike.
Finger dike. Didn't your dad ever tell you to go walk down that dike over there, over them bushes?
Yeah.
I think I'm a dyke chuck. I am. I like eating pussy and I like how it looks. I like boobs. I like cuddling little sweet little girls that don't look like dykes.
Isn't a dyke a lesbian?
Depends how much
I think that's what I am, is a lesbian.
Really?
Yeah.
I
don't like dick. You ain't put a dick in me. See, I've heard them all saying that.
You keep your dick away.
Exactly. And that's me. That's me right there. Keep your dick away from me. I think I'm a lesbian. I never thought about that. That's possible.
You're a dyke.
I am a dyke. Full blown dude. Look at me. I can't. Isn't a dyke like a rough lesbian? I mean, I'm not the...
Yeah, I'm pretty sure the dyke is the man.
Exactly, the more rougher around the...
Yeah.
I mean, I'm the pretty one. I'm the more rough around. I got a beard and stuff. I mean, I've got to be a dyke if I'm going to be a lesbian. I'm trying to figure out if I am. I think I must be. If there's a dyke and a... Okay, a dyke and a what?
A dyke and a girl.
A girl?
Oh.
I'm not a girl.
No. So you're a dyke.
I have to be. We figured this out, dude. I'm going to post about this tomorrow on Loose and More Friends. I'm going to come out of the closet. I'm out of the closet, dude. I need to make a video about that. You know what would make a good video is like going to a lesbian club and trying to pick up other lesbians because you're a dyke. That would be awesome.
Hey, I'm one of you guys.
Wear a shirt that says get that dick away.
Why would you do that?
To work. It'd be the auction, maybe.
Right now?
Well, in an hour or two.
In an hour or two? It's midnight.
Yeah, that'd be two.
What, do you have a bedtime?
Right? Get a curfew or something?
When I wake up at 5:30 in the morning,
let me guess. Your mom's going to be pissed.
Think about that. You've been getting up earlier, and you've been staying up later.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, you're looking.
Think about it. You're living more life.
Look at that. Look at you. To the fullest.
More tired. Not really. Just
more tired? How tired?
I'm tired.
You're not tired. I'm tired right now, too. I'm getting to be tired. It's late.
It'll be a long drive ahead of us here in a couple hours.
Are you guys really going to L.A.?
Well, we're all going.
You're going too.
You have to work tomorrow. You don't want driving us?
Yeah,
I ain't driving this time. Are you joking me?
Midnight.
He's making jokes. It's fucking going to be 2 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, wait, fuck. Please tell me you're kidding.
You want to think about getting some sleep there, bud.
Please tell me you're kidding. Oh, fuck. You're kidding.
Yeah. Okay. I'm not. I might go, but
I
know. I know I'm going Thursday.
As long as it's like 6:30. I mean, as long as I have a few hours.
No, we're gonna have to do an LA one soon again.
Have you been to an auction?
Did you go to an LA? Did you go to LA early?
No, that was when I was a baby about. But I will go for sure. Obviously now.
You were a baby really about getting up that early?
Yeah.
It was late.
I'm telling you what. If he says in time. You know, I my eyes will be open. So help me God. This is the time you are up.
Dude, it was like 3:30 in the morning.
Full soup.
It was 4.
We left off
Fine,
damn
it was
early.
4 in the morning.
Huh?
We left awful damn early.
Where? When?
When we went up to LA. We went up to LA 2 or 3 times.
What time did you leave? Early?
3:45. That's usually what time I get up because it's easy to go like this when I'm tired.
Oh,
because okay. I'm always up late and somebody will ask. And right about that time, I'll yawn and I'll go.
Well, 3, 4, 5.
My number at the...
Oh, I got you.
My number at the auction, whenever I get to pick them, is usually 23. Like
23. Just to do that. Wow.
No, tomorrow.
Wow. Are you really going tomorrow?
2 hours.
Tonight.
This afternoon.
He almost made me be late.
I know.
Wait, you're going to L.A. tomorrow?
Tonight.
Today.
Right now. In 2 hours, if I go.
2 hours.
I can't tell if you're joking or not.
If I go to the auction for Wednesday, I have to be there. I got to leave here at 3:45 or 4 o'clock. What am I supposed to do? Go over there and fall asleep by 1:30, 2 o'clock and try and get up at 3:45?
That's what he wants you to do. That's what he wants you to do, Nathan.
I'd have to fucking take an energy vitamin and stay up, drink a bunch of water to where I don't have to pee all night. Keep walking outside to pee. You won't go to sleep. I guess at some point in my age, I'll start peeing the bed and I won't even get up. But until that point.
You have to get turned over every couple hours. But.
Yeah.
Come on. So you're really going to LA tomorrow, today?
Jeez Louise! I hope so.
I thought you said you were joking.
I never said I was joking. You did.
What do you call it for confirmation number?
426896.
Here.
Wait, so.
345.
You're going today.
Yeah.
If I go to the LA auction, I've got to leave in a couple hours.
You need to burrow underneath your truck and a little bit of wink eye because you're driving. And I, you put my life in danger.
Honestly. This is where I don't know if
Thursday's for sure.
Okay.
But if I go today, which is the big auction.
Then we have to go Thursday.
Thursday only has 700 cars. Tomorrow they have 2,600 so far. Tarantula just crawled on my leg.
Fuck, don't you think they don't?
I hope it wasn't.
It could have been. They've been known to be in this area.
Tarantulas.
Oh yeah, the cactus dwellers.
Jeez.
They're vicious too.
That's all I need.
Cole and I was working on a job site. Instead of talking, boss stops for a minute. He's like, what the fuck? And we look. Yeah, up from all this board comes a big old tarantula. He walks across the board. He walks right in the middle of the circle of this guy before we're ready to start working. And Roger goes, oh my God, a tarantula. Oh my God, he's so cool. Mark. And everybody's like, oh, it's a real tarantula. He's like, all right, everybody, hold on. It's all right. He'll be fine. Let's just go back to work.
He'll be fine.
And everybody stopped. He walked over. He goes, what? All right, so today, what I need you guys to do, it was like, oh my God.
We stepped on it?
Yeah, it was a big one, too. You could just hear it. Kind of
pop.
Oh,
God. Just stepping on a tarantula.
This guy was all trying to save it.
And then you just shut the fuck
the fuck was a tarantula doing in Montana anyways?
No, it was in Arkansas.
Oh, that makes more sense.
It was down in Arkansas working.
It's like, he must not have been out long, because he would have froze up.
He was only out up there for 6 weeks. Like a groundhog.
There you go. Came out of hibernation. Yeah, it sucks to watch a stand-up comedian and they're not funny.
Yeah. All-time favorite comedian. Who's your stand-up comedian all-time favorite?
I think the guy that Alex showed on Netflix. John Mahoney.
Like, you just picked someone you've seen recently? You've never seen him before and now he's the funniest guy?
That's the only one I know.
You haven't seen any other funny people?
Like Seinfeld, Jerry Seinfeld. You guys have heard of Jerry Seinfeld. He's funny. I haven't really seen much of his routine, though, just, like, watching.
So you don't watch much stand-up comedy?
No, I don't.
And then you go and pay to acting classes, and they're telling you to work on improv?
Yeah.
Might want to watch some stand-up comedy.
Yeah.
Specifically improv.
That's an idea.
It is. It's an idea.
I like Mitch Hedberg.
I had a girl do that to me once. I was like, don't you even put your finger near that fucking thing again. That fucking shit, bitch.
They call this the Mitch Heimer.
Then I did the pirate with her. You know what the pirate is, right?
Uh-uh.
That's where when you're about ready to come, you pull out and you squirt it in her eye. Yeah, and then when she's like, what the fuck? You kick her in the shin. And then when she's hopping around holding her eye, she's a pirate. She's got a high patch in one leg.
Wow.
I can't remember what it's called. The dolphin.
The dolphin? What's the dolphin?
You fucker from behind you in the spoon position. Then you pull it and shove it in her ass real quick. And she's all like, oh.
And you go up and she doesn't like how she tastes, or she won't taste herself, there's a problem. There's a definite problem.
That's an indicator.
She should be willing to, she should like how she tastes.
She should want to, yep.
That's a red flag.
The reason she likes, she should like that.
No, if it's a red flag, that's a different story.
Yeah.
She's on her period.
Yep. If it's a red flag, she's on her period. But that's still okay, because then you get your red rings.
You can go do it in the shower. That'll ease it up a little bit.
You can see that.
Soak them in hot water. Stop the flow. Come on, baby. Anything you can do, stop that flow. It's not so much the blood, it's the stringy stuff that gets to me.
Right.
It's the membranes.
Oh.
Yeah.
There's membranes?
No, it's not just blood. It's like,
blood,
it's like stuff.
What
there.
Is it?
It's like,
I want it to pee once a month because you're
wasted eggs.
The old egg and putting in a new. That's what a theory is. You didn't know that?
There's a certain smell. You can tell.
Oh,
you can tell.
Jesus.
Oh.
You can tell when they're on that time.
Did you live on a? Oh.
They get hornier. Street? They get hornier too.
Oh hell
do
yeah!
They really?
Do. Oh fuck yeah! They
seem
do.
To.
Yeah, I thought it was like just blood. I didn't know there was other things going on there.
Oh yeah, it looked like you got like bloody boogers all over your wiener.
Oh. You are right.
You don't want to come in there either. You get like this pink foam.
Looks like a fucking strawberry smoothie.
That's interesting.
But I'll tell you what though, nothing like coming up looking like fucking Count Dracula.
Yeah. No, that's gross. I can't even laugh at that shit. That's why I said you gotta make a choice at that point. Is it period sex or anal? It's a big choice in life, and a man's gotta pick one or the other.
I'll put it this way, it's sex, period. So it don't matter.
Take your pick.
Girl, you got one of three choices. Egg in the butt.
No, I got two choices. I'm not much for it. Head's just simple. That's like, head is for when, like, you're driving and you don't have anything else to do.
Head's when I'm watching a good movie and she's annoying me.
That's good, if she's talking too much. Other than that, if it's like in bed, it's got. I want to get laid or like go more that route. Head is just too simple. Yeah. She needs to work harder than that.
Like, bitch, shut your fucking cock washer. Get over. This dick ain't gonna suck itself.
Which would be interesting.
I don't think you'd get very far on that.
I don't either.
You'd probably be going little hands on that night.
Your own hands on.
Well, we've learned a lot. Yeah. Starting with how she should like how she tastes, and on from there.
The sick, bloody anal sex.
Sick anal, huh? Well, I mean, she should at least act like she likes how she tastes. Oh. I mean, you were just down there. It's rude not to act like she likes it.
Right.
But no! You know, that don't work for me.
Yeah, yeah. No, right.
The fuck do you mean no?
You fucking made me do it, you sick bitch.
Right. What is it, like battery acid coming out of there? Is my lips going to fall off now? Do I look okay? You got a mirror?
What's that rap song? Okay, so. I ain't fucking her. Me neither. Bitch, go home and wash out your beaver.
It was some kind of NWA or something like that, I thought. Dope Man. Something like that. 655 cars at the border.
655 cars?
Yeah, and it's government cars, too.
Really?
Well, there's... Yeah.
Those are good. Damn right they are.
They got all them diesel trucks there right now. Charger, a police charger.
That'd be cool, especially if somebody got shot in the back of it. You know what I mean? Like police brutality.
There's been a couple there.
Have a nice story behind it like that?
Yeah. Story helps sell the car, right?
Yeah. Fucking Trayvon Martin got killed in the back of this car.
Oh, man.
Too soon?
Well, maybe not. But
I think we got plenty of
time. I think it's been a couple of years. It's still sad, though.
Not really. Why is it sad?
Why is it sad? I mean, is that even...
Right. Why would you drag a dead
guy in
the back of your fucking police car?
Right, exactly.
Ruin the goddamn car. Why would you...
Why is it sad?
Why...
Don't ask what I mean and try and hypoglycerize it.
Yeah.
Just fucking, like, answer my question.
Why
is it sad?
A child was killed.
He's not a child.
A child.
He's 16.
Punk.
He's a fucking big-ass fucking guy. He was mad enough to already been busted many times. He's mad enough to be a criminal.
He was going to the store to get Skittles.
No, he was being a criminal and doing criminal activities.
How do you know?
Because it was in the police report. Because what's his name said he did. No. You know.
Because he's dead.
He's dead. Yeah, that's a good reason.
Yeah.
That's a start.
I guess everyone's got a different take on it.
The take is like you shouldn't be a little hoodlum. Dress up like a hood rat and fucking act like a hood rat and act all cool and like act like you own shit. Yeah, he deserved to fucking, he was coming at somebody. Obviously there was a problem. Somebody just didn't walk up and say, hey, boom.
That's true. Why would someone do that?
That doesn't happen that much. If they do, they take out 50 of them.
That's a good point.
The movie theater.
Yeah, that kind of shit. I think that's totally sad. I mean, I hope they fucking hanging people up by the nuts. That, I don't know. I don't know what happened, but I don't think it was just the guy was up to like just getting Skittles.
Oh, Kool-Aid?
Codeine.
Codeine?
Yeah.
Oh.
He had everything it took to make the purple drink. He's going out and being like Lil Wayne.
Yep. Scissor.
Okay.
And drink sipping on scissor.
Scissor.
There was lots of little things I don't know. But
I don't know, it seems like there's a bunch of different stories.
There is, but at the end of the day, not guilty.
He was acquitted, yeah. I think.
Not guilty.
Not guilty? Oh yeah, not guilty.
That's the law.
And same thing with OJ.
Yeah.
Not guilty.
Yeah. They weren't
and although a lot of people still think he did it, that's whatever. I mean,
OJ's a saint.
Who knows?
They got him on the second stuff, but it was the third stuff. I think they finally got him on.
Yeah, he's in jail again, right, OJ?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. He's
you get away with murder, and then you're back in jail. You know, I mean, you're the luckiest man, and then you're back in jail.
If I had good luck, I'd want to get away with something besides murder.
Yeah.
Like stealing $100 million.
Oh yeah.
Now we're talking. That's only if I could get away.
Oh yeah, if you can get away with it. Zimmerman, George Zimmerman. That's
who it was. He just had the thing.
Sent by God to protect all of us.
He's protected us very well.
He's only been arrested like 5 times since he came.
I know.
Yeah. Dude, what a douchebag.
Little douchebag.
What was it, like a neighborhood watch or something?
Yeah.
But that signifies our rights and the way things are supposed to be in America. That's definitely...
Yep.
Carry a gun. And
that's a lucky...
No, you have that right. Totally have that right.
That's true.
And...
Now I can see why...
You should be able to defend yourself.
I can see why so many people are for it and against it. Seems like it's divided half and half in the country.
Only because we're raising a generation of pussies.
Yeah. Well, and it seems like there's so many more mass shootings and...
Because the people are pussies and they get their little feelings hurt and they start fucking... Okay. Oh my God, I'm gonna snap and like, and then they fucking go kill everybody because they're fucking pussies.
Mentally ill, something.
Pussies. Can't handle reality. Can't deal with decisions. Can't... Pussies. Pussies. Didn't I like pussies. Pussies is simple. Well, pussy's not simple. Pussies are.
I know what you mean.
I don't think people should run around shooting people.
Oh, no, yeah. I mean, that's...
But I think if you see somebody that's up to nothing, up to no good, and they're on the neighborhood watch, and obviously he's in the good end of stuff, it's not like he's doing that to be a bad guy.
I think one thing is that they were saying how you shouldn't go up to that person and confront him because he's not a cop. You're supposed to call the police, and then the police will go out.
Not a neighborhood watch.
Not a neighborhood watch. Hey, what are you doing over there? What's the deal? What are you doing?
No.
Hey, what's the deal? Get away from that.
You know, whip around real quick and whip off.
Who is he to do that, though? He doesn't have the authority to go up.
Sure you do. Hey, what are you doing there? You're fucking looking in somebody's window? You're walking in somebody's yard? Yeah, you're the neighborhood watch. That's what the neighborhood watch is. You don't just watch them do it. Nah, buddy. If you're a fucking pussy... Otherwise, you can be proactive in the deal. And you can be like, hey, somebody's breaking into my neighbor's place. Hey, look, there's that guy that doesn't fucking live in this neighborhood, obviously.
Yeah. That's true.
I mean, if you're the neighborhood watch, you know who's around.
Well, I think that's what people argue, is that if he called the police and had the police deal with it, then no one would have died that day.
Who cares if somebody died? It saved us the trouble of having to prosecute the little thief. Lifetime of it, too. Guaranteed. Bad person. They should have shot his mom and dad too. Lined them right up.
Everyone's got different.
Fuck that, his grandma too.
Grandma too. Think of what we just saved.
Get them off there.
Oh, gasoline started right up, huh?
I only caught 2 cars on fire this time.
You got enough kindling, that's for sure, over here if you need it.
Yeah.
Right. Oh yeah, right.
That's what gets that good, nice bed of coal.
This stuff works great.
We'll have to make him barbecue when he's here, since that's his fucking name. Your kid, Cole.
Cole. Go make some coals, Cole.
I just love the taste of the grill. It's so nice.
I think that's gas, huh?
That's probably what I'm tasting.
Like a gasoline taste. I'll tell you what, even like a Whopper or a In-N-Out, a home-cooked burger, if you got the right seasoning and stuff, it's really good.
Oh, yeah.
So much better for you.
Is this what charboil?
That's what that
is.
It's like a green bug.
Is it a mantis?
No.
Oh, it's a June bug.
A June bug, yeah.
It's June bug.
Oh, June bug?
Then you tie a little string around him and let him fly around.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Cook that buddy up.
Horsefly,
cook him up and eat him. Cook him up and eat it. That thing.
No thanks.
Extra protein. That's 5 grams there.
Really?
I don't know about that.
I wonder how it died.
I don't know. You write an obituary?
I get that from my mom. She's so... She loves it.
Mom. Your mom.
My mom.
I get that from my dad. I shoot him.
There we go. Now, do I spread it out now, or do I wait the 15?
I tell her to spread it out right when I see it. Chuck, you want to give your boy a little girl help here?
Do I spread it out now, or do I wait the 15 and then spread it out? I spread it out when I plant it. Wait till it get a good white out. You know, starting to show white on the edges?
Uh-huh.
You need to get scald on my cooking there. I'm gonna throw a lot of that.
Okay. And you set that extra smell. Extra smell, yeah. Look at this boy. This is
cooking
fast.
Huh?
This is
cooking fast.
Oh, yeah. This cooks so quick with these charcoal. Wow. That is just so cool.
I think they used to.
Maybe not anymore.
Now they just kind of peel off, probably.
Hey, look at my ring back.
Sorry. It's got like a reflective tape on it.
You think it's reflective tape?
Reflective tape, yeah, he had that added at the aftermarket shop.
Yeah
right.
He's a cholo June bug. That's it. Chuck said he wrecked on the way to get his pinstriping. Popcorn?
Well, on my tongue. I'm just trying to pop that bug in my mouth. You hear that crunch.
You're not really gonna, are you, Chuck?
What's he gonna do?
Not really. I might. I don't know, dude.
What are you gonna do? Dissect it? For science? Huh? Are you gonna squish it? No! No! Oh my god! Why would you do that?
I don't know. I didn't think he's gonna do it. He's looking for protein.
Why would you do that?
Because you're taking a long time. You didn't cook them burgers all at once.
That's cheaper than your burger. Oh my god. I can't even believe that just happened. You just ate that.
It's strong like bull.
Oh,
that's
so gross.
The key is you keep chewing.
You just can't stop.
You ever had chocolate covered ants?
No.
Oh, they're pretty good.
Are they?
Yeah.
That's. Oh, dude, that's gross.
On your leg, right there.
Oh my god. That's disgusting.
He saved you a leg, and you didn't even partake.
Right? That was a drumstick.
That's like sharing.
Oh, what did it taste like?
Doombug?
Chicken.
Really?
That's, oh my god.
It always tastes like jerky.
And that wasn't even like an ant. That had like stuffing.
No, that wasn't ant. No.
Oh, it was.
Out here in the sun, it's kind of probably jerkied up a bit, huh?
Oh. Yeah, it's probably cooked.
I got shell all over my mouth.
Oh.
Reflective tape? How'd the reflective tape go down?
Pinstripe is hard to get down. Wow. Clear coat's not dry. That is something else.
That'd be tough, Josh.
That's gross. That's such a big bug.
One man's gross is another man's Big Mac.
There you go.
Wow.
Picture your legs.
It probably has some kind of like vitality to it, and you're gonna walk around the boner for the next 3 days.
Strong like bull.
Come out with like a new thing, like. June bug will.
Good for your gang.
Yeah.
Ain't no wrong by gang.
That'd be interesting. Like, how do you know that? Well, I just ate it one day. And
yeah. I popped in a June bug and it was like.
Think about the first guy that ate an egg.
An egg?
Yeah.
Yeah.
My egg comes out of a chicken's ass and he's like,
Right? Yeah.
I think I'm gonna eat that.
Fucker.
And he had to fucking crack it. He had to open it up. He didn't just have to eat it. He had to like.
Open it up.
Fuck with it.
And it's a baby bird. So that's sick. So you're eating a baby bird.
Yeah, it's a good thing you only eat egg McMuffins.
Right? And it's odd because, like, eggs taste good.
They're good kind of for you, maybe.
No, they're really good for you. Like, why don't you eat the egg yolk? Isn't that, like, the best part, like, in terms of healthiness? What? Oh, at cholesterol.
There's 75 calories in an egg. An egg white is 60% of the egg. Egg white has 20 calories or 15. It has 15 calories.
Wow.
And the rest has 60. 60 in the yellow, 15 in the white.
Wow. And the egg white's the majority of the egg.
There's a little bit more of the egg white than there is of the yolk. From there, 90% of your cholesterol is in the egg yolk for the day.
Jeez.
So you have two and you got 180% of your cholesterol.
But isn't cholesterol good for you sometimes?
There's LDL and HDL.
Okay.
Some of it is okay for you. But nothing's okay for you in 180% at one meal, and then you eat another 100% throughout the day.
Oh, okay, so it's easy to overdo it.
Like, I can eat five egg white omelet with some cheese in it. That's a fucking lot of food.
That is.
You can eat a three egg omelet, and it's less food.
And more cholesterol, more calories.
300% of your cholesterol.
So it's not so much...
Extra 180 calories.
So it's not so much the cholesterol that's bad, it's the calories that are bad.
Both, for me. I'm okay. Trying to... Like, basically, egg white is the easiest thing you can eat that has the least amount of calories of anything.
Wow.
And it's the most filling and has the most protein. Egg whites are wonderful.
They
the most
delicious.
Wonderful thing you could eat.
And I think it's, you know, almost sort of like a placebo, like, because you know it's healthy for you, so it makes... It's good.
Take a pan, put it inside there with that griddle or whatever, and fucking... Put a bunch of egg whites on there and put them up and then chop one of them burgers up and mix it up with it. Oh, man. Throw that in a burrito shell. Oh, you got yourself a nice burrito.
Get some cheese in there.
Cheese and some salsa and shit.
Oh, that'd be so good. Wow.
You ever get turkey sausage?
Okay,
turkey sausage is pretty good. They have packages. It's pretty good.
Really? Turkey sausage. That does sound good. Sort of like turkey bacon.
Probably better and closer to the in the sausage side. I can't do turkey bacon.
Why not?
I guess because bacon's so good.
Oh, I know. Bacon's delicious.
I love bacon.
Oh.
So I don't eat it.
Really?
No, if I do. I used to get them. If you go to Carl's Jr.'s, you can get them to make your bacon and then drop it in the deep fat fryer.
Really?
Oh, it's good.
Deep fat fryer. Wow. That's like a...
Have them make your bacon and order extra, extra bacon to where you got like 6-8 slices. And then have them drop it in the fryer for a few seconds.
Really?
Oh, man.
That's like bad.
Oh, yeah.
Bad on top of that.
I used to go, I was trying to work out, and I used to go and I'd work out and do the hardest workout of my life. Me and my buddy Alf would come home and just get like 10 sides of bacon and some morning sandwiches.
That would set you back.
Eat like fucking 1,200, 1,500 calories in the morning.
Wow.
Of the wrong kind of food. If I'd ate turkey, I would have fucking been in perfect shape by now.
Well, you just gotta work a little harder. I mean, it is what it is.
Nah, fuck it. I need to start eating candy, ice cream, and fucking chocolate chips all day.
Well, that's why...
Dad's here. He just dropped off the... Actually, we got a tire guy moving in next door. He just dropped off the CL500. He's taking pictures of it and the white car today. I'm gonna get the seal done before it gets too dusty, and we are moving right along. Part of the problem, sorry, I had to check if I was on. Part of the problem with black cars is this. This was washed a couple hours ago, and although I love how a black car looks, I hate keeping a black car looking that way. There's watermarks, water spots. I wasn't the one that detailed it. It was brought to me like this from my dad. So, I'm going to use their detail. Okay, well, we'll talk to you in a while. After I get done wiping this bad boy down, I don't know what else we're gonna do today. But I got a few cars around here. And actually, I'll just leave this on. I'm gonna go over to the church. They were actually, look at all that wood. Would you? I would. I would.
Brake. Girl's driving the car last. Brakes on.
Ooh, it's hot. Hot, hot, hot. Okay. We're out of here. Get some pictures. Get the CL sold. My mom is driving the AMG. And my dad's now second guessing that. He's like, you know, she's curved rashes and tires kind of bad. This car is a nice car to drive. Tell you what, I'm kind of gummed up with cars in a big way. All kinds of cars. This thing is full of cars. The minute I got it full of cars, I start getting people hassling me. I don't know what's going on. You still on the pedals and stuff, dude?
Oh, no, no. Just walk checking things.
Come on now.
It's all. I just want to really make sure.
Okay, I'm going to get going. I don't know where I'm going. They just changed my whole thing.
What, the church people?
Yeah, they're all over back there.
I wonder why.
I don't know, and I wonder when I drive through this shit how my wheels are going to look. So let me back through this shit real quick.
Oh, my God.
Fucking environmental fucking hazard people here. Paint down the gutter. They can't even do a good job of that. They're leaving me all gutted up with paint.
Oh wow, look at, geez, they did that pretty quick.
Yeah. Okay.
Alright, I'll work on everything that goes to the list. Not for the excursion, but I watched that. Should I just watch it right here? Okay.
Don't get that wet. Don't get that wet.
Oh, yeah, the Mercedes.
Well, there goes a Montana. I'm actually going to take night pictures in my interior video of the CLK. Nice car. Awesome little car. What are you doing?
It's start.
It won't start?
Yesterday just going good. Just giving it gas and running like a top. You know. Start it up again. It'll start.
Okay, I got the Mercedes totally done. And I'm done with the day pictures of the Cadillac, which unfortunately I wish it was the night pictures. But I still got time to get the night pictures, so. But now, to the bottom of that.
Burn it.
Yeah, well, you can't really feel it, I guess. You can, kinda.
Just gets hot.
Well, it's overheated. It won't take no more video. So I'm gonna take the video off the card. How much longer do I have? Fuck. And then that's the last one. I'll have two done today. Yeah. So the neatest thing about that being that way is the fact that then the Cadillac can be put anywhere. That takes care of that, gets it out of the way.
Well, as soon as he gets done with that, we're good.
So are you done now, or are you still doing stuff?
Yeah, no, I'd like to get the keys and put the auto parts in that trailer.
Oh, I got the keys.
And then that'll get me.
Give me like 1 minute. Can you throw that in this car, and I'll have them by the time you get to me? The door panel. Well, here we go again. It's getting late. There goes the sun. It's my magic hour. I love this time for my night pictures, which to me means interior. Look at that motor. Just clean as can be. All under the speed limit.
All under the speed limit. Good, I think you like it.
Diablo?
Yeah.
The yellow ones are the hottest.
The yellow one is?
Yeah.
Are you sure this one's not the hottest? You guys aren't.
No,
you
that's
get my
smoke.
Chain?
That's the smoke.
That's the smoke, the heat flavor. Thank you.
Thank you. You put a drop in your
tongue. Dude, try that.
Squirt that in your mouth.
This is wicked spicy.
Wicked spicy, not just spicy.
Wicked. Holy shit. What are you trying to do to me?
Can we get a bunch of ketchup?
I always forget we have ketchup.
And I know, I did. You used to have it out. Thank you.
Wonder why they don't anymore.
Thanks, Chuck.
Hey, that's not a problem. Finish it or what?
This is so spicy. Oh, my. This is really spicy.
It's not that bad. I'll make a salsa someday.
You're going to make salsa one day?
I just made some a few weeks ago.
You made some?
Yeah, buddy. Habaneros help.
I don't know how to make salsa.
I'm 41 years old, dude.
2 cups of salt, half a cup of soda.
I know how to make all kinds of stuff.
Like what?
Whoopee.
What's that?
Your mom's green.
Is that like ice cream? Did you say mom or mum?
Mum.
Okay.
Oh, mommy. Is that nummy, mommy?
Charging more for chicken than potatoes.
Is that normal?
Depends on if you're a chicken.
Oh, yeah.
It sucks if you're a chicken.
Well, normally chicken's cheap, right?
Cheaper than beef.
And it's healthier. So that's like the one time where a healthy food is cheaper.
It kind of is.
I don't know. Kale.
That's true. Yeah, you can get really. Yeah, you could do that. You could say that.
Lettuce.
But do you want to eat kale?
Exactly. No one's gonna have kale as a main course.
I would if I had blue cheese.
Oh yeah. But then that would probably get unhealthy quick. I don't like blue cheese. I don't like the taste of it.
You do?
I don't like the taste. I mean, it looks like mold. First of all, I think it is mold.
It is.
So. Really? I didn't know that.
You didn't know that? You don't teach that in school nowadays?
No. I'm not a doctor. I'm not like going.
You don't have to be a doctor for that. I think I even know who still discovered it. I can't believe they don't tell you that stuff nowadays.
Right? I mean, they could. We could have learned that. What about Hong Kong?
What about Hong Kong?
No, Hong Dong.
Oh. Sorry.
Hong Dong.
Okay, there we go.
Who's on first?
Huh?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Who's on first, Chuck?
Oh, okay.
What? No, what's the second?
At it. I wonder if they, like, came up with that routine.
Yeah.
Wow. That's like genius.
I can't believe the guy's in acting school and doesn't do the whole Abbott or any of the stand-up stuff.
I gotta look into
crazy.
What do you study?
Not a damn thing.
Not a damn thing. Does your teacher have boobs?
It's a guy.
Does he have boobs?
I don't think so. But it's nice though, it's like a city.
What?
There's only like 5, 6, 7 people in there, so it's nice. It's not, I was afraid it'd be like a 20 person class, and then it's like, what are you paying for if they don't, there's no like, you know. So it's better having a small class, I think. It's cool.
It's almost over.
Yeah, I think this is my fourth one coming up, and I only have, yeah, it's like almost halfway over. But then I'll, I can keep it going like every month for like a smaller price or whatever.
He's got a hold of you now. You're going to keep bucking.
Well, no.
Buying into that.
I don't plan on doing it forever, but it's great experience and it's good to have on a resume. Maybe it'll help me get jobs and stuff like that. Oh. You need to have, like, training. I know a lot of people. She wanted her own
thing. Woo!
There's something I
can get. Some.
Yeah.
But if you don't like it,
die hard.
I'm going to let her taste it.
Die hard, that's it.
You like this?
You are good.
You like this?
Wait, is that really it?
Okay, she's going to like it.
No, Die Hard is the bald guy. The bald guy. What's his name?
The Rock?
You know the movie Die Hard.
All five of them.
I can't think of his name.
Kerry Savala.
No.
His name is Kerry Savala.
I don't.
I can't tell you
the
secret.
What the heck is his name?
We're gonna be drinking the Ninja
Turtle when I can't tell
you
how to
make it. I can find out. Megan. Do you mind not calling it? It's like this small. It's no. You're wrong.
I did have them
have
last time.
You want these, Josh?
You sure?
You're gonna eat them?
Yeah.
Okay.
You don't want them?
No, I'm gonna steal two of them.
Yeah, take half.
That's all I want.
Okay.
Who are you gonna tell me?
Hey. Yeah.
Well, why don't we give Breeder a couple, didn't you, Joey?
She won't eat them.
Really?
She has a heartburn.
She has a heartburn? She's a dog.
No, that's mean.
How do you know a dog has heartburn?
You can tell. They get all stinky-ish.
Ooh. Oh, heartburn. Heartburn.
So you got the sign. See, sometimes you give these moves, but you can't sound good. Another time, he's like, what? You got a dog breeder? I do not do cheese of any kind.
Weren't you just eating cheese?
Yeah, we're nachos.
Okay.
Did you really just ask me that?
Cheese.
Yeah.
Ask me again. Oh, come on, ask me again.
I don't want
to. Just ask me again.
I don't want to ask her again.
I'll answer you this time.
Do you really have a gun?
Of course! Doesn't everybody?
Do you have a gun?
What were we just talking about, hunting?
Oh, so...
What do you think we're doing? Running these deer down and strangling them?
Next time I catch you next year, I'm going to scratch your belly to death.
I can't believe it's so unbelievable.
Right. Not just,
you got multiple.
Did your mom let you go out during the day, or did you guys just kind of go out after nine, between nine and midnight?
Do what?
Out of the basement?
Under the stairs or something.
No, we just didn't grow up with guns, that's all.
I feel bad. It seems like you grew up without a lot of shit. Like, you had an ocean right there, right? You grew up with the ocean in Boulder.
Oh, yeah. On the coast.
So you, but you grew up with the ocean.
Yeah.
The ocean.
What?
You know about the ocean.
Yeah, it's water.
Right, he got out here and asked me if this was the Atlantic Ocean.
Did he?
He did. He actually did.
I don't know.
You're like, oh, this is...
I don't know what it was.
Were you a straight-A student at school?
Mm-hmm.
Straight-A student?
No.
You're like, did I get A's? Is that what you're saying?
No. Like, I know I'm a smart kid, but I didn't take it seriously.
No.
Just didn't care.
Hey, Josh, pretty good to have along. He's young enough to distract them little girls from the mama for you. You need like a wingman app. That'd be great. Wingman app. I'll be right there. Hey. I'm at Dick's right now. I'll be down the road. Which bar? Okay. See you in 10.
See you in 10.
Don't talk to any of them.
Don't talk.
That's
your wingman. Take this one.
Hello, Uber wingman.
That would be really interesting.
Wouldn't it? It's gotta pay more.
Oh, yeah.